varnanam artha sanganam rasanam chandasam api mangalanam chakartarau vande vani vinayakau bhavani shankarau vande shraddha vishwasarupinau yabhyam vinana pashyanti siddha swantasthamishwaram vande bodhamayam nityam gurum shankar rupinam yamashrito hi vakropi chandra sarvatra vandyate nana purana nigamagama sammatam yad ramayane nigaditam kvachidanyatopi swanta sukhaya tulasi raghunath gatha भाषा निबन्धमतिमञ्जुलमातनोति अतुलितबलतामं मेम शैलावदेहं दनुजवनकृशानुं ज्ञानिनामग्रगण्यं सकलगुणनिधानं वानरानामधीशं रघुपतिप्रियभक्तं वातजातं नमामि नीलाम्बुजश्यामलकोमलाङ्गं सीतासमारोपितवामभागं पाणौ महासायकचारुचापं नमामि रामं रघुवंशनाथं नमामि रामं रघुवंशनाथं हरि ओम् हरे राम 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 सीता राम 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 सीता राम 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 सीता राम 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 सियावर रामचंद्र की जय इफ यू आर जॉइनिंग अस टुनाइट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम वी आर सीइंग सुंदरकांड ऑफ द श्री रामचरितमानस लास्ट नाइट व्हेन वी लेफ्ट इट हनुमान जी जस्ट एंटर्ड इनटू लंका आफ्टर ओवरकमिंग सो मेनी ऑब्स्टिकल्स एंड वी सेड दिस इज सिंबॉलिक ऑफ द ऑब्स्टिकल्स दैट एनी साधक विल फेस as he is in search of the bliss of the self. He will face all those obstacles. And it is important that we respond to each obstacle in the appropriate way. And you see, there is different strokes for different folks. It is said, yeah. For Mainak Parvat, he respectfully declined. Huh? And then for Surasa, there he outwitted. And then for Simhika, he removed, yes, eradicated. And then for this Lankini, he transformed. Transform the inner personality of that Lankini, you see. So we respond to each thing. Actually, these are all very, very simple lessons for life also. Eh? Each parent has to deal with each children in a different, each child in a different way, isn't it? You can't deal with all the children in the same way. Because everybody is emotional, physical, intellectual constitution is different. So you have to see how to deal with them. You know, one child, he will make his own sandwich. He actually takes pride in making his own sandwich. And other fellow, bechara, oh, bapre. You show him 100 times and he's not able to do that. So then you have to make his sandwich for him. Like that. He'll be different. Everybody is different. So like that in life's situations, we have to see the situation and respond appropriately for all things around us. Not same. Otherwise, life becomes very boring then. This is a true thing. Yeah? I once went to a doctor in Varanasi. I was living in Varanasi for 4 years. So his head was bent on the table like this. And he had a pen and he had his prescription pad. I sat there. Well, there was a line in front of me, so everybody's coming and sitting there. And his hair was not lifting from that. Ji, problem kya hai? He's sitting there. And you just tell him, acha, theek hai, acha, ye khadi ro. And he without looking also. 25 rupaya de dijiye. And he just put, and his hair is only your hair. And anybody who comes in, he looks like same prescription also. Of course, whatever he gave me didn't work. But that's a different story. So you have to, every patient that comes there will come with something else. Na? So we have to listen and, you know, diagnose properly and then prescribe and all like that. So Hanumanji is a very nice lesson. He's also, he sees all of them and we have to deal with them accordingly. Maybe she blesses him, Lankini, and he goes into Lanka now and he keeps looking there everywhere for Sitaji. And then, not finding her, but he finds, now this will be after number, but just before number 5. Just before Doha number 5, one line before. The Chaupais don't have numbers in this in the original text. The Dohas have numbers. Huh? So just before Doha number 5, it has one line. Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram भवन एक पुनि दीख सुहावा हरि मंदिर तह भिन्न बनावा श्री राम जय राम रामायुध अंकित गृह शोभावरणि न जाई तव तु वृंदतः देखि हरषमन श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. Lanka Nisichara Nikara Nivasa Ihakaha Sajjana Karavasa Shri Ram Jai Ram. Manamahu Tarka Kare Kapilaga Tei Samaya Vivishan Jaga Shri Ram Jai Ram. Rama Rama te sumiran kina hriday harsh kapi sajjan china Shri Ram Jai Ram. Ehi san hasi kari hau pehichani sadhu te ho inkar jahani Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. Vipra Roop Dhari Vachan Suhaye Sunat Vibhishan Uthita Aaye Shri Ram Jai Ram. Kari Pranam Poochhi Kusalai Viprakao Nij Katha Bujai Shri Ram. Kari Pranam Gita Mahari Dasana Mahakoi More Hridaya Priti Ati Soi Shri Ram Jai Ram. Ki tum Ram Deen Anuragi Ayau Moi Karan Barvahi Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai. Tab Hanumant Kahi Sabha Ram Katha Nij Naam Sunat Jugalatan Pulakamana Magan Sumiri Gun Gram Siyavar Ram Chandra Ki Jai Sharanam Sita Rama Siyavar Ram Chandra Ki Jai Sharanam Sita Rama Siyavar Rama Chandra Ki Jai Bhavan Ek Puni Dikhasu Hava. He saw a most beautiful little house. Then Hari Mandir Taha Binna Banava. In front of that house, there was a little Hari Mandir. This is a very typical North Indian scene. And this thing was taken to Trinidad and Guyana and Fiji and Mauritius. And there's a house and always there's a little Mandir in front of the house. So in Trinidad up till now, you'll see hundreds of little Mandirs like that. In front of the house. Separate from the house. This thing is tradition, it comes from Ramayana only, here, from this Tulsi Ramayana. So he saw this beautiful little mandir there. And on the house, Hari Mandir Taha Binna Banava, Rama Yudha Ankit Griha. On that door of that house, Rama Ankit was there, means the bow and arrow of Rama. On his door. And Sobha Varina Jai, so beautiful it was. Then Nava Tulsika Brinda Taha Dekhi Harashi Kapidai. Means to say, there was a little young tulsi plant. That also tradition very much there, in front of the house. Throughout India, I think. Then, one thought struck him. You know, Hanumanji seeing all of this in Lanka. Lanka? Nisichara Nikara Nivasa, where all these Rakshasa only live. In Lanka? Iha kaha sajjana karabasa? How some sajjan, some sadhu is living here? But this is actually, this also demonstrates a very, very strong point which all of us have. Means we get easily prejudiced And we feel, when we hear Lanka, that means everybody in Lanka has to be wicked. I mean, it's at the time. Yeah? Like, for example, I once went to the prison. Means for a visit only. Yeah? When you go in there, and actually this is a prison on an island offshore. So you think all people there are hardened criminals. Huh? So you go there with some prejudice in your mind. Bah, pray, how I will talk to these people? I had to go to talk to them. When you go there, you realize that they are like ordinary people. They've done some mistake, something wrong. They talk like everybody else. So all your stereotyping and all your prejudice and everything, just go. But we are quickly prejudiced in so many ways. So, this thought, in Lanka? Some sajjan is living. The things we have heard of Lanka, I mean, in his time. And you know, you wouldn't believe how this carries on, you know. Because, like, for example, we are cut off from that part of the world, living in this part of the world for a long, 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 long time. Even now when we hear about Lanka, we still think everybody is like that. When you don't know, you see, get so prejudiced. So he's thinking, how some sajjan is living here? Manu mahuttaraka kare kapi laga, as he was, you know, mulling this thing over in his mind. Tehi samaye Vibhishana jaga. That house belonged to Vibhishan. As Hanumanji was mulling this over in his mind, how Sajjan is living here, Vibhishan woke up. So Hanumanji did not make any sound. Vibhishan just woke up at that time. I told you the Brahma Muhurt time, when he came in dark in that time in the morning. Yeah? Then, Rama Rama Tehi Kusumirana Keenha. Got up and he uttered the name Ram. Ram, Ram, Ram. When he woke up. When we wake up, oh my God, it's already morning. Just now only somebody told me that, you know. So 6 o'clock? That early? But he got up at Brahma Murti and happily Ram, Ram, Ram. Like that. And it is said that whatever we go to sleep saying, that only we'll get up saying. So you could see what he went to sleep saying. What he went to bed saying. So, he uttered the name, Hriday Harshakapi Sajjanak Chinha. And Hanumanji was happy to hear this thing now. Oh, he's chanting Ram also. Then, Ehi Sana Hati Kari Hau Pai Chani Sadhute Hoi Na Karajahani is a very famous line. I have to meet this Vibhishan. Which of course doesn't know his name. So I have to meet this person. Come what may, I have to meet this person. Because, and the second part of the line is, Sadhute hoi na karajahani. There is never any loss in meeting a sadhu. Even if he whacks me on the head, that will be for my good. There is never any loss in meeting a sadhu. So I must meet him. Then Hanumanji, typical meeting anybody new. See, Viprarupa Dhari Bachana Suhai took the form of a Brahmana and he went there. And he called out. Called out to Vibhishan. Tulsidashi doesn't write what he said. But if he went in Chinmaya Mission, he'd say Hari Om. Ram Ram, he may have said. Then, Sunata Vibhishan Uthita Aye. So Vibhishan heard that and called, maybe Ram Ram, and quickly got up and came there. Kari pranam puchi kusalai. Vibhishan did pranam to Hanumanji. Hanumanji is a form of a Brahmana. Did pranam and asked, how are you? Vipra kau nicha katha bujai. Tell me, who are you? Where have you come from? All this. But before Hanumanji could answer, Vibhishan himself suggests who he might be. Ki? Tum haridasana ma koi more hriday priti ati hoi. When I see you, my heart wells up in joy just by seeing you. Are you one of Bhagwan's great servants? Good guess, eh? Dasan, see? Even though he's veiled, under Brahmana's roop. The magnanimity and the magnetism, the personality of Hanumanji is also shining through that veil of a different roop, isn't it? So it makes the heart of Vibhishan swell like that. Sometimes you say that in life also. I don't know how you say in your language, but in Trinidad language you say, my mind take him. My mind takes him. Yeah, like that. Sometimes you just feel a natural love for somebody who you don't know. Like that. So, Vibhishan is telling, my dear. And then he suggests again, Ki, tum Ram, Dina, are you Ram himself? Who loves the helpless, you know? And already he's hinting, I am helpless here, you know. Are you Ram himself? Who loves the helpless? Ayahu Mohi. Mohi, Karana Barabhagi. You've come here to bless me. Are you Ram? Then, see the next line, how nice in Doha. Tulsidasji writes. Tab. See, Vibhishan has asked several times and suggests also who he might be. Then, Tulsidasji writes. Tab. Then, Hanumanta kahi sab Ram katha. Hanumanji told whole Ram katha. He didn't tell who he was. He told whole Ram katha. So several times Vibhishan asked, who are you? But he told Ram katha. And I tell you, in our case, even somebody asked about Ram katha, did we tell about ourselves? We love to speak about this typical human being. He loves to speak about himself. Let me tell you, typical conversation between two human beings. What is that? Mr. A will say, do you know, just now, we came from Long Beach, California. Mr. A telling to Mr. B, we came from Long Beach, California. Do you know what fellow was attacked by a shark there and this and that? It's all he's telling. Mr. B not listening to this thing. He's already planning his katha, what he'll tell when this fellow finishes. When he's finished, he's waiting for him to finish. So he's not listening to anything. I don't want to hear because something which he said in the first word or second word, that clicks another story in this fellow's mind. So he's already planning that story, you know, going on. And where children are involved. Hare Rama. This is how human beings like to talk about them. Me and my children and my and this and that. We like, but is Hanumanji, how wonderful. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Then, this is one place, several places in this Ramayana, the whole Ramayana is told again. Yes. Sava Ram Katha. All Ram Katha he told. And after it was finished, when the whole thing was over, Nija Naam. Not Nija Katha. He told you, tell your katha. He did not tell his katha. He told his name. Did not even say that I am a dasa of Ram. Only that my name, Nija Naam. What a wonderful message for Sunata Jugala Puni, Sunata Jugala Tana Pulakamana Magana Sumiri Guna. And now, one vakta, one shrota. Hanumanji is Vakta telling Ram Katha. Vibhishan is Shrota listening to Ram Katha. And both of them, hair standing on ends, got drowned, immersed in Ram Katha. Vakta Shrota. It took a while. I mean, Ramayana comes to a stop in several places like that also. Because the Vakta and Shrota became immersed. Bhagwan Shiva also at many places became immersed. He goes into meditation sometimes 67 years, 67,000 years or something. So Ramayana has to stop many places. Then when he comes out after 67,000 years, then again Ramayana starts. Like that. Sunahu Pavana Sutta. Raini Hamari. Listen, my dear Hanumanji. how I live in this Lanka, you know. Let me tell you now. He says, Jimmy dasananhi mahu jiva vichari. I live like the tongue among the 32 teeth. One tongue and soft, soft, soft. Komal. And the teeth, hard and... In other words, all these other rakshasas in Lanka, they are like the teeth. And I'm like tongue. But let me tell you something. This may look like Vibhishan is complaining. But Vibhishan is not complaining. This is a very nice line. Let me tell you. See, one Mahatma, he was on his deathbed. So lying there, all his disciples were standing around. So one disciple said, Guruji, jaane se pehle, hum logon ke liye kuch upadesh de dijiye na. Because the Mahatma told, I'm going to drop my body now. Before you go, you please give some teaching to us. So that Guru was silent for a little while. Aged. Silent. Then he said, okay, now, you look in my mouth. You see tongue? Yes. You see any teeth? No. That is my upadesh. What? Muh mein jeev hai, daant nahi hai. That is upadesh. He said, no, my dear. You become like the tongue. Kyunki jo komal hai, wo rahega. Jo kathin hai, pehle nasht ho jayega. Who is soft and komal and tender, they will stay, they will persist. And those who are rough and tough and hard, they will go. You become like the tongue. So, Vibhishan is telling to Hanumanji, see, I'm like the tongue and they're like the teeth. And really speaking, who went and who stayed? All the other rakshasas went and Vibhishan stayed, you see. It's not a complaint actually. Otherwise, the tongue is there, poor fellow, in between, and the teeth are always. But I tell you, this morning only I was telling in Vedanta class, the tongue has the last say. The tongue is the most powerful organ in this body. I told you, na? Most powerful. You know, one day, the teeth bit the tongue. And after biting the tongue, the teeth smiled. What else? So the tongue kept quiet. And I said, oh ho. The tongue waited patiently. And while they were passing in front of that pub, some drunk men were coming out. And the tongue insulted those drunk men. And those fellas gave one blow and all teeth. All fell out. See how easy. So, the tongue will always have the last. Yeah, last say, last laugh. Who laughs last? Best, yes. So, he's not complaining, but this is how I live here. It's a very wonderful message in all of that. Huh? And he asked Hanumanji a very nice question right there, Hanumanji. Bhagwan will remember me. You think? I am a rakshas, you know, in this Lanka. Tamas deha, tamasic body, everything about me, rakshas clan I was born in. You think Bhagavan will remember me? Hanumanji tells the most asame adama sakha sunu mohu par raghubir, that even though, see, I am kapi, chanchal, I am monkey, my mind is chanchal. Pratale jo naam hamara, if anybody takes my name in the morning, I tell you, Hanumanji telling, If anybody takes my name in the morning, that day that fellow will not get food also. And I, by nature, monkey, chanchal, means fickle-minded and all of this. But Bhagwan has also showered his grace on me also. That is Bhagwan. The Lord is waiting to shower his grace on anybody who comes before him. In this same Ramayana, he'll tell later on. Whoever that person be, he has killed a million brahmanas and he has come to me. I'm waiting to shower my grace on it. That is Bhagwan. And he has showered his grace on me. Why he will not shower his grace on you? And he reassures Vibhishan. And now Vibhishan tells him how to go into Lanka, where Sitaji is. He tells all the whole story. Where is the Sitaji? So now, he follows the direction of Tulsidaji very interestingly. You know, I wonder many times why he chooses certain words and all. Juguti Vibhishan sakal sunai chaleu pavana suta bida karai. Juguti means yukti. Yukti, he has to give direction using yukti. Actually, it's a very interesting thing that you have to be very, very careful about the words and why he'll choose a certain word at a certain time. Most people are not very good at directions. Eh? Thank God today for GPS. And if you're in India and you ask anybody for direction, Ram Ram. Huh? You ask, where is that dukan? Are idhar hi hai. Kone pe hai. He'll tell, right? Yeah? Right, he'll tell. And you're walking miles and that thing is not coming. Don't ever ask for directions in India, I tell you. Hare Rama. So, juguti word means how he gave good direction, and because Hanumanji was looking all of this time and he could not find. And see, when a person who knows, and this is the idea, one who knows, when they point out and they're able to point out very clearly, that person will go straight to that goal, isn't it? In the next line, he reaches Sitaji. See how fast? So there, he is Deshikaha, the word we saw this morning. Deshikaha. How everybody is playing different roles at different places in this Ramayana, you know? One who doesn't know and one who knows. So the one who knows points out to the one who doesn't know. But he has to do that yuktitaha. With yukti, with great logic and rationality, and has to point out very clearly, you see? That is the idea. So, he points out to him, and in the very next chapai now, I want you to see very important chapai. Eh? Please listen to this now. This is just one chapai before number 8. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Ram Jaya Ram Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Ram Jaya Ram Dekhi manahi mahu ki na pranama Shri Ram Jaya Ram Baithehi piti jat nisi jama Kris tanu sis jata ek beni Shri Ram Jaya Ram Japati hridaya Raghupati guna shreni Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Ram Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Ram Shri Ram Jaya Ram Ram Siyavar Ramachandra ki Dekhi Manahi Manukina Pranava. Hanumanji does pranam to Sitaji in his heart. She's there. He's here. But he does pranam to Sitaji in his heart. He doesn't go there and do pranam. And this is significant because I have to tell you very important thing. I told you on the first day in introduction how the whole Ramayana is really, while it is a historical antecedent, something which happened in the past, at the same time, Bhagavan can achieve so many wonderful objectives with one act. So the advent of Bhagavan Ram achieved that historical feats, whatever transpired there at that time. But at the same time, his life is also a great symbolic reflection of what actually goes on in real life also, and in the universe and also. It could be seen at the same time, while it could be seen historically, it could also be seen symbolically. Yeah? And don't think that Bhagavan cannot achieve. If he cannot achieve, then he's not Bhagavan. What Bhagavan is then? He has to be able to achieve numerous things in one stroke. So here now, you all Vedanta students from this ashram studying Vedanta for so many years, so you would have heard in our Taittiriya Upanishad, listen, you know it, you see it everywhere in our Tattvabodh, everywhere you see. Etasmat akasha sambhutaha. Have you seen that? From that reality came akash. Akashat vayu. Vayu agni. Agni rapaha adhya prithivi. From space came air, from air fire, from fire water, from water earth, like that, right? Now see, that means from space air, from air comes fire. So Hanumanji is Pavanaputra. Hanumanji is fire, isn't it? He's Pavanaputra, he comes from air. Pavanaputra. So then that means what? He's fire. And then Bhagwan Ram has put Sitaji where? In fire. So Sitaji is in fire. And when he goes there, he does pranam to Sitaji in his heart. Because who is there is Maya Sita. Who is here is real Sita. You see? And the very same way, the happiness which we are all looking for is really a reflection of the happiness which is? You see this thing? In quarter of a chaupai, Tulsidaji is able to achieve this whole Vedantic teaching. In quarter of a chaupai. Who is out there is a reflection of who is here. And all happiness and all joy really is in our heart. And if something in the world gives joy, that is only a reflection of the joy which is in our heart. So you see, when he goes, the first thing he sees, he does pranam to Sitaji in his heart. So like this, he sits. Now, the story has to continue. But here, interspersed in this whole story, Tulsidaji goes on giving all the Vedantic truths and Vedantic teachings in between. But the story has to go on now. You see. So now, he sees her there sitting in this condition. And story has to go on. Why? Because the jiva has to learn about the consequences of actions. The jiva has to learn how to deal with situations in life. The jiva has to learn how to respond to things which he encounters and all of that. You see? So the story has to go on because of that. But that doesn't mean to say that he's not able to capture all Vedantic truths at the same time inside of that whole story. So now, he sees Sitaji sitting there in a very, very dejected, despondent condition. And her hair is tied up and her body has become lean. She's not eating and this and that. Nija pada nayana diye mana ram pada kamal lean. She's looking at her own feet, head bent. This is all, head bent means, regret. Head bent in regret. Regret being some bad decision I made, some things I said, this, that, you know, regret. Head bent down, looking at her feet, despondent. But at the same time, in her heart, she has established the feet of Bhagwan Ram. Like that. Paramadukhi bha pavana sutta. He now seeing, like this, Sitaji in that condition. In the comeback to the story, he also became very miserable to see her in that condition. like that. And Dekhi Janaki Deen, seeing her in that helpless state. Now, very interestingly, at that time, when he is thinking now, what is the next step? Ravan enters the picture. Now, just now, when he was looking everywhere for Sitaji, he had seen Ravan, but Ravan was sleeping. The first introduction of Ravan in Sundarkand is Ravan is sleeping. I mean, that is sign of tamas there itself. And Ravan admits his tamas. In Aranyakand, he himself tells, in this tamasic body, I don't think I'll be able to get mukti, you know. He tells to himself, he's speaking to himself, I don't think I'll be able to get mukti. Therefore, I will go and I will make enmity with that Ram. And when he kills me, I'll get mukti. Ravan was the first, I tell you, listen to his thoughts in Aranyakand. I'm going to make enmity with him. If he's Ram and he kills me, I will get mukti. If he's not Ram, I will kill him and I will get the princess. Ravan is the first person in the world to teach win-win situation, you know. Because Ramayana is before Gita. Bhagavan Krishna tells Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita in the second chapter, is win-win situation for you, you know. But that Gita came after. Ravan taught the thing before. So, either way, I win. Very clearly he tells in Aranyakanda this thing. So now, here he enters. And he has a whole, he's flanked by all his Rakshasis and all the, whoever he had in, all his various wives were there with him. And he tells Sitaji, now you have to, actually what he's telling her here in this passage, just look at me once and I'll make you my head queen. He's telling in front of all the other queens also right there. I'll make you, I'll put you above all the other queens. Sitaji, she took a blade of grass and put it there. And she insulted him like anything. She was looking at the blade of grass and talking. And she told, my Rama is like the sun, and you like Khadyot. Khadyot means a firefly. Where's firefly? And where's sun? Like that she went on telling some strong words to him. Ravan got angry like anything. And he drew that Chandrahas's sword, you know, to kill her. Then Mandodari told, no, you can't kill her. They're not proper. You king, like, whatever act is that? And Mandodari saved. And then he tells, okay, I'll give you. Masa Divas means 1 month. In 1 month, if you don't accede to my wish, just to look, actually, what he's telling in Tulsi Ramayana, just to look at him even once. She doesn't look. And if you don't accede to my wish in 1 month, then I'll cut off your head. And he left. Saying that. And he left the Rakshasis in charge of Sitaji there. And then, among those Rakshasis, there was one of them who was called as Trijata. Trijata was in charge. And the Rakshasis started tormenting Sitaji. She said, no, stop. Last night I saw a dream. And in that dream, there's all big things are going on in the Ramcharitmanas, you know. In that dream, Ravan is riding on a donkey and going south. He's going to Yampur. Yampur means the city of Yamraj. And a monkey burned down the whole of Lanka. So in other words, whatever is being seen, or whatever is going to transpire is already being seen by this Trijata. And so many people ask like that, Swamiji, you mean we can see what is going to happen in future? Or whatever we dream can be real? Well, it can be. See, I'll tell you something. This question will always be there among human beings, you know. When I dream something, can that be a vision of the future? It can. It may not be also, but it can. Because whatever is going to happen tomorrow has to already exist. You know why? Think, huh? Suppose tomorrow morning you have to be eating cereal and milk. Right? That fact or that truth has to already exist because Ishvara is Sarvajna. Isn't it? Think, just follow that logic again. Eh? If Ishvara knows everything, that means he already knows what you're going to be eating tomorrow morning, correct? You may not know, but that knowledge is already existing or not? Because he's Sarvajna. So it means every piece of knowledge is already existent. So if the knowledge is already existent, then there might be ways to tap into it. Correct or not? So if the person's mind is very quiet, very sattvic and this, and you can tap into the cosmic mind, you'll pick out pieces of information. It's possible. That is all. All things are already existent. In this world, na sato vidyate bhava, na bhavo vidyate sataha, means all things which are, and which is not, and which is not, cannot be, and which is, cannot not be. That means everything is already, so that knowledge of what you're going to be eating tomorrow morning is already there in the mind of Ishvara. Otherwise, he's not Sarvajna. He's not all-knowing. So you can then tap into the knowledge like that. So it's possible. You see? So now, she told, and then all the other Rakshasis became scared. Okay, they started treating Sitaji with respect and reverence, you know. Because she saw this dream, you know, like that. Now, Hanumanji thought, okay, Ravan has gone away. Trijata has told a story. He was listening to all of this also. And he said, monkey has come into Lanka and burned down Lanka. And he was looking around. There was no other monkey. He was the only one there. He's hearing his own story also, you see. Like that. And now this will be after. Let's see. After number 10, Trijata, she tells her story. And after Kapikari Hiridaya Bicha Dini Mudrika Da, this is number 12. Number 12, huh? You have to jump. We have to jump because we only have till Friday, you know. Are you okay? In one jump, Hanumanji reached from India to Lanka. So we'll also have to do some. This Sundarkand starts with jumping only. Kapikari Hiridaya Bichar Dini Mudrika Daritaba Janu Asoka Angar Dini Harashi Utikar Gaheu Siyabar Ramachandra Ki Jai Pavan Sut Hanuman Ki Jai Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai Bolo Bhai Sab Santan Ki Jai. Now after all those other two, Ravan came and Trijata told her story and all. Now Hanumanji thought, now maybe I should do something. He thought in his mind, Kapi Kari Hridaya Bichar. He thought, thinking. This vichar word is used several times coming up. It is used until the point where Meghanad releases that arrow, the Brahmastra, to Hanumanji. And that was the last time Hanumanji did vichar. He thought, and then he said, better I surrender to this arrow. And this vichar word is used until that point. Because we do our personal vichar until we surrender. And after that surrender, total surrender, it is Ishvara who works through us. The vichar is not required thereafter. So kapikari hridaya vichar, he thought. Then dini mudrika dharitava. And he dropped that ring. He was on that tree. He dropped that ring down. Your story, you know. He was bringing that ring in his mouth and all. And what Ram was written. on that ring. Then Janu Asoka Angar Dini Harashi Uti Kara Gaheu. She got up with great joy. She thought that the tree had given some bit of fire so that she could consume that body. Tava dekhi mudrika manohar Ram naam ankit ati sundar. Seeing that Ram naam on that ring, she was very, very happy and all. Chakit chitava mudari pahichani harasha bishada hridaya kulani. Means to say, at the same time in her heart now there was joy and sorrow. Joy to see the ring of Bhagwan Ram. That means to say something associated with Ram is there. But sorrow, if this ring is here and Ram is not there. Oh, who could have gotten that ring? Jiti kosakai. Who could really conquer this Ram? Who could conquer Ram? Because if his ring is here, that means he may have been conquered. Ajaya Raghurai, he who is unconquerable. Who could conquer? Who conquered him? Mayate asi rachi nab jai. Nai jai means, and nobody could fashion such a ring. You know what it means to say, you know? The name of Ram is also beyond Maya. Ram is beyond Maya, but his name is also beyond Maya. Maya cannot fashion such a name. Now see the interesting part from there. Sita mana vichar karanana. When she saw that ring, she started thinking in so many ways now. Shri Ram Jay Ram Jay Jay Ram Shri Ram Jay Ram Jay Jay Ram Shri Ram Jay Ram Sita Manavi Char kar nana madhura bachan bole o hanumana shri ram jay ram jay ram jay jay ram ram chandra gun barne laga सुनत ही सीता कर दुख भागा श्री राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय जय राम लागी सुनैश्र वन मन लाई आदि ते सब कथा सुनाई श्री राम जय जय राम जय जय राम श्रवणामृत जय कथा सुहाई कही सो प्रगत होती किन भाई श्री राम जय राम श्री राम जय जय राम तब हनुमंत ने कच चल गयउ फिर बैठीमन विस्मय भयउ श्री राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम बोलो राम 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 सीता राम 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 बोलो राम सीता राम 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 बोलो राम 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 सीता राम 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 बोलो Ramachandra ki jai. Sita mana bichar karan nana. In various ways she thought about this ring. What could have happened to Ram? How does ring reached here? Madhura bachana bole Hanumana. And then Hanumanji spoke in very sweet words from that tree where he was sitting. Ramachandra guna baranai laga. This is a very famous line. Some of these lines are so sweet. Ramachandra guna baranai laga sunatahi sita kar dukha bhaga. That when she heard the ambrosial words of the katha of Ram, all her sorrows went away. And this is the best way to send away sorrows, actually. What we do, you know, we have one sorrow. We get something to remove that sorrow. That's something which will result in sorrow only. That is our methods. The other thing which we are getting to send away our sorrow eventually will lead only to sorrow. It is human beings, a peculiar human being. You know, this is a flame. And this is his hand. And his hand is burning on that flame. You know what a human being does? He puts ice on top. Instead of pulling his hand or removing the flame, he puts ice. That is no solution. But all our human solutions are like that only. The solution to all things in this universe really is Bhagwan. Yeah? If really, we are just going in circles. In Trinidad language, we call that spinning top in mud. Spinning top in mud means there's no traction. Nothing will be able to go, no movement. So, when he spoke those words of Bhagwan Ram, Sitaji's all sorrows went away. But then she said, oh, such ambrosial words, such nectarine words. Lagi sunai shravana mana lai adhyu te sab katha sunai. Means this is another point where the whole katha of Ram was told again. Ramayana inside? Ramayana. Ramayana squared. Then she said, shravana amrita jehi katha suhai kahi so prakat hoti kina bhai. My dear, whoever is telling these nectarine words of the katha of Ram, why don't you show yourself? Whoever is telling, she doesn't know who is telling it. That is also another important thing. It doesn't matter who tells, it will send away my sorrow. She did not see who was telling. But it will send away our sorrow. The katha of the Lord. Taba. See the next line now. This is the more interesting line. Taba hanumanta nikata chali gayau. When she said, whoever is telling this katha, please show yourself. Then Hanumanji came in front of her. Piribaiti mana bismaya. Then again she lost all confidence. But now she's seeing this monkey in front of her. She sunk into depression again. Look here. This is a very interesting portion of Ramayana, I tell you. This Hanumanji, when he goes in front of Bhagwan Ram, he goes in the form of a brahmachari. When he goes in front of Vibhishan, he goes in the form of a brahmana. Everywhere he goes, he's taking some other form. And in Ayodhya Kand, when Dashara Ji Maharaj heard that Sita Ji is also accompanying Rama to the forest, you go and you see there, Dashara Ji Maharaj says, Sita Ji is going? My God, even when she sees the picture of a monkey, she gets scared. Not a monkey, picture also. She gets scared with that. And she's going to the forest. And now, Sitaji, who is of that type, when Hanumanji is taking such divine forms everywhere, when it is time now to take some form, he comes there like monkey now. Hare Rama. The other times it was not necessary, you know, not necessary to go in front of Bhagwan Ram as anything. Bhagwan Ram is Ram. And he's not scared of monkeys. So time now went to go in as some little brahmachari, you know, Batu. He goes as pure bred monkey. Then Mahatma Log, they sit down and go, why Hanumanji had to do like this? You go in front of Sitaji like a monkey form only. knowing she will be, and she said, really? Vismaya bayau. She sunk into depression again. So Mahatma Lok said very nicely, you know, look here. In front of this one, you can pretend to be this. In front of that one, you can pretend to be that. But in front of mother, you can't pretend to be anything. You have to be who you are. And I tell you, you ask all our swamis, they know that best. In front of mother, we whatever we are outside, but when we go there, then mother will tell, what has happened to your hair? In front of mother, you are you only. Yeah. So, he goes like that only in front of Sita. Then, Rama Dut me Matu Janaki. I am Rama Dut. When she heard that again, he caught her attention. Satyaksa Pata Karunani Thanaki. See that word? Karunani Thanaki. Only Sitaji used to call Bhagwan Ram by that name. Karunani Than. So if Hanumanji is uttering that name, that means to say he had to have come from Ram. And see what the art of communication. You tell that in the first line. Otherwise, some people tell a long story before they get to the point, you know. The art of communication, you tell that in the first line itself. Karunani Dhanaki. So it means to say you get to the point quickly when it is necessary. Because she is sunken. So quickly he has to. And this word, you know, Karunani Than. This name of Ram is, he's the ocean of kripa, compassion, mercy. I'll just tell you a little story. I once heard this thing. How only Sitaji had known that name of Ram. And found that name to be so nice. Karunani Than. So I went to sleep thinking about that name. Karunani Than. Really. And that night, this bhajan just came in my mind while I was sleeping. And I got up and I wrote it down. Many bhajans came in my mind when I was sleeping, but I'm too lazy to get up to write it down, you know. But this one I wrote down, see. Yeah? The words are very simple. If you follow also, you can, if you listen, you can follow. Karunanidhan Prabhu Shri Ram. Karunanidhan Prabhu Shri Ram. Karunanidhan Prabhu Shri Ram. Karunanidhan. Karunanidhan Prabhu Shri Ram. Sitavallabh Hanumat Sevita. Sitavallabh Sitavallabh Hanumat Sevita. Bharat Pran Hari Priya Raghuram. Bharat Pran Hari Priya Raghuram. Bharat Pran Hari Priya Raghuram. Karunanidhan Prabhu Shri Ram. Karunanidhan Prabhu Shri Ram. दशरथ नंदन संत जन रंजन दशरथ नंदन संत जन रंजन दशरथ नंदन संत जन रंजन दशरथ नंदन माया प्रेरक मुक्ति प्रदायक माया प्रेरक माया प्रेरक मुक्ति प्रदायक प्रदायक करुणा निधान प्रभु श्री राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय सिया राम जय जय 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 राम जय सिया राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय सिया राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय सिया राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय सिया राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय जय राम जय सिया राम जय सिया राम श्यावर रामचंद्र की जय। यह मुद्रिका मातु मैं आनी दीन ही राम तुम कह सैदानी राम हिमसेल्फ गेव मी दिस रिंग टू ब्रिंग टू यू एंड नाउ सीता जी हियरिंग ऑल ऑफ दीस थिंग्स फ्रॉम हनुमान जी ऑब्वियस क्वेश्चन इज राम आई हैव नेवर सीन राम टॉकिंग टू अ मंकी बिफोर नर बानर संग कहू कैसे हाउ वॉज देयर सम अलायंस बिटवीन नर एंड बानर मीन मैन एंड मंकी कई कथा भाई संगति जैसे एंड हनुमान जी टोल्ड द होल स्टोरी लाइक दैट हाउ इट हैपेंड एंड सीता जी गॉट शी रिगेन्ड हर कॉन्फिडेंस कपि के वचन स प्रेम सुनी उपजा मन विश्वास शी रिगेन हर कॉन्फिडेंस ही हैज टू बी टेलिंग द ट्रूथ जाना मन क्रम वचन यह कृपा सिंधु कर दास शी न्यू इन बॉडी स्पीच एंड माइंड ही वॉज अ दास ऑफ राम ही वॉज अ दूत दास ऑफ राम सर्वेंट ऑफ राम लाइक दिस शी गेन कॉन्फिडेंस नाउ द स्टोरी will take a different direction, you know. And now she has already gained this confidence in him. Now, interesting things will happen, but we will have to see that tomorrow. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva ॐ शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम